sick my...
Get your girlfriends and wives to get sanitary pads, the cheapest pads plus the cheapest tampons. You all know what the tampons are for? You shove it right into the bullet wound, and the tampon expands and applies pressure to the wound.
So if you've been wondering, how is the Russian war effort in Ukraine going? Not well. When they have to draw up hundreds of thousands of new recruits, give them maybe 2 weeks of training, and in terms of their equipment, tell them to get their own tampons to stuff into the bullet wounds that they will very shortly be suffering from. That's kind of a bad sign. I mean, one of the major stories of this invasion from the very beginning is that the soldiers being sent in by Russia are ill-equipped for the fight. They have not improved on that situation, that much is clear. And the Russians seem to understand that as well, which is why some of them apparently are willing to pay up to $27,000 to escape the country on private jets. Actual, like public flights have been sold out, and people are actually being stopped from leaving the country because so many would not want to fight. But anyway, requests to leave have gone from 50 to 5,000 per day. So they're overwhelming the private jet industry. You know, supply chain issues are a big problem in this day and age. To give you another idea of what Russians think about this, there was a report of mobilized Russians calling a hotline to ask how to surrender. Now, bear in mind, grain of salt on this. This is coming from the Ministry of Defense of Ukraine. So maybe it was a handful of people or something. Let's not go crazy. But the idea that some of these troops will head over to Ukraine and then surrender rather than be killed by the thousands, pretty easy to believe at this point. And honestly, those in positions of power and authority in Russia seem to get it too. Take a look at one of the strategies they're using to reassure soldiers that no, it's totally cool, you'll be okay, you should head over there. The head of the Orthodox Church said that Russian soldiers who die in the war against Ukraine will be cleansed of all their sins. That's a consolation prize, I guess, just not one you can use in this life. No, when you're telling the soldiers that are heading to war, not go get them, you're invincible, just I guess you'll get some credit in heaven or something. That's not a good sign, JR.
People like to criticize, make fun of, say, you know, when there's terrorism from Middle East and they say, look, these guys think that they're gonna have 19 virgins in heaven and then Muhammad's gonna look down on them and be like, good job, you killed yourself in that attack. This is very similar, right? To be able to use religion to push people into doing these types of things because that's just their stock in life. That's an old school thing. People are gonna go to war, I die, it's gonna be honorable for my family and my country. Who cares about me? I'm going off to heaven. That's changing, bro. And it's much, much harder to convince people that that should be their entire purpose in life. As they see and are reading the tea leaves and seeing how bad things are going for other folks that maybe they've seen or heard from these things from, and they go, I got a wife and kid. What? Like there's this center of your life where now people actually value it more and think I should live it rather than give it to someone else for the glory of whatever it is. That glory is going away. They got to try and find a new way to convince people that their lives mean nothing. And Donald Trump has done that pretty well here. But you see a lot of these comparisons, a lot of these similarities, and how you got to use religion to get people to then kill themselves for your purpose. It's getting harder and harder, and I'm not sure where these folks are getting $27,000 from this many to get out of the country. But I guess good luck. This is a horrible situation.
I guess you could try crowdfunding or something, like desperate times call for desperate measures. But anyway, I hope that many are successful in avoiding this, like that none of them should be forced to do this. It's just crazy. They already were suffering so many casualties. It reminds me of, you can look up the numbers of the average life expectancy of drafted soldiers dropped into Vietnam during that war. Like the expert Russian troops were getting destroyed in Ukraine. These fresh recruits who don't want to be there, it is going to be devastating, the casualty numbers, and it shouldn't happen. It doesn't need to happen.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.